Malaysia for one championship, Masters of Destiny. Daichi Abe opening up ferociously. Single leg takedown attempt here. Alvarez straight back onto his feet. No filling up process whatsoever. Swinging and looping punches here. Daichi Abe, the Pancrase welterweight world champion. One of over 140 martial arts world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Ev Ting takes the outside thigh kick, the human highlight reel. Trained in Auckland, New Zealand in preparation for this one. Oh, and he catches it! Ting's in trouble! Daichi Abe looking for the ground impact. Ev Ting getting caught.
Good job by Ting to regain his wits. He's got to keep moving, though. Trip right there.
Ev Ting's got to recover. A long way to go. 3:45 in this first round, and Ting's been caught clean.
Abe's got to slow down, be patient. Looks like Ting might have recovered. He might be able to get him right here, though. Beautiful trip again.
Daichi Abe all over Ev Ting in the opening round.
Ting's still dangerous.
And Ev's been cut. Overhand right from the Kiwi Malaysia. Looping hook there from Ev Ting.
Watch the right hand of Abe. Good job by Ting, but it's hard to take down a judo black like that.
Locking onto the single leg is Ev Ting on his back now. Daichi Abe.
Ting trying to go deep half on him, but you can see the heavy hips and the judo black belt sprawling out now. You can see Ting trying to work his way in.
The Pancrase world champion in control. Opening 2 minutes has been all one-way traffic.
Ting's trying to attack the leg right here. Trying to go into a knee bar. Might be able to work his way back up on top, but Abe's got heavy hips. Back up on his feet. Ting might have regained his senses, but watch that right hand of Abe.
Now the roundhouse kick from Ev Ting. Drops the lead hand down to the midsection. Goes upstairs. Ting pops combination.
Ting still wobbled. Hasn't quite regained his equilibrium.
Jab, beautifully done there from Abe. Launches forward again. What a show so far from Daichi Abe of Japan. The judoka, the Pancrase world champion. Oh, now he gets dropped. Here comes Ev Ting, the overhand right. And Ev Ting again, another right hand. What a Donnybrook.
He's got to be careful swinging in like that.
Overhand right, left hook from Ev Ting. These men are giving it their all. They're pulling out all the stops. There's no holding back in the opening round.
Michael, we're only 3 minutes into this thing. These guys are throwing with some serious match-ending power.
Daichi Abe resets. He's been rocked by Ev Ting. Oh, and again, he catches Ting. A short right hand as Ev Ting overextended.
You can see the timing of Abe. That's what's catching Ting off balance right here. As Ting's trying to come in, that's when Abe is connecting. That's what's wobbling Ting.
Looping punches, Ev Ting, but nowhere near the distance. Jab to a hook there from Ting.
You have to keep in mind, though, that Abe is dropping down from welterweight. His match against Sapo was at welterweight, so he's coming down to lightweight. And he looks really sharp at lightweight.
1 minute remains in what has been an absolute corker of an opening round. Wild looping right hand there from Ting, thrusts out the jab. Abe edges forward, both men trade leg kicks. Jumping roundhouse kick there from Abe. Throws the right hand with a lot of force. Spinning heel kick from Ev Ting. Goes to the body, hooks it. Tried for a judo trip takedown, couldn't execute it. Ting was looking for the liver off the right hand. Jump walking right hand from Ev Ting. What a round. Both men have had their opportunities. Overhand right from Ting, backs off Daichi Abe. kick right on the bow from Ev Ting. What a show! It's ONE Championship Masters of Destiny.
Wow, looks like Ev Ting's fully recovered from that onslaught brought on by Daichi Abe. Watch this. Oh, look at that jab. Beautiful timing. And then, right there, as Ting tried to come back from the jab, we saw him overhand right to the side of the temple. That's what wobbled Ting. But Ting did a very good job of regaining his senses. He was able to shoot in, and then we saw that ground and pound, that beautiful trips coming from him. Really well done from Daichi Abe in that round.
And a couple of luminaries ringside. ONE Championship superstars in the house, the sold-out Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur. First round, my word, that was tremendous. What action, what tenacity. Second of three.
Round two.
Everyone here in Kuala Lumpur on the edge of their seats. This one brought to you by Global Citizen. Left hook there from Ev Ting. Outside leg kick from Ting. Good punch there. Now the human highlight reel would love. Oh, good attack. Trying to take the back of the Pancake World Champion.
Good job by Ting getting up on top, but a beautiful sweep there by Abe. Used that Kimura trap to pull himself over. Now he's got the headlock. Ting's trying to work his way to the back. Good job by Ting, almost dumping out the ring ropes here. He's got the back, though, of Abe. He's got that triangle, locked up that leg. It's gonna be hard to restart that position. I think that's why the referee's letting him work a little bit.
Back elbows there from Daichi Abe. Referee trying to get them away from that bottom rope. Good work there.
Yeah, I don't think the referee wanted to break that. He realizes what a possible problem that's going to be to restart that. Good job by Ting to maintain that top position. Ground and pound coming.
Back to their feet in the corner here.
Good job by Abe to work his way back up to his feet. Now he's got that leg in between the legs of Ting. Good balance shown by Abe.
3:25 remains. Second round of three. Stellar contest here. In the ONE Championship lightweight division. Snappy jab from Daichi Abe, the Pancrase World Welterweight Champion. Open trade jab. Overhand right, Abe.
You can see those awkward trips of Abe as he tries to step in, utilize those judo trips on Ting. Ting's tried to figure it out so far, and now he's starting to have a little more success in creating that base.
And a great night so far for Malaysia. Big win for Gian Ratsuan earlier on over Joe Marie Torres. They'll bring the house down again if Ev Ting can defeat Daichi Abe here. Yeah. Over from Ting, going for the headache maker. Big outside leg kick.
See the way Ev Ting throws that overhand right. He's really dropping his head down to commit a lot more power to that overhand right. But he's got to be careful. If Abe can see it coming and time it correctly with an uppercut, he might send Ting time traveling.
Grazed him with the elbow there. Body ahead, quick off the left hand from Ev Ting.
1 minute left in the second half.
He just ate up a minute on the time clock, just staying in that closed guard.
Ev Ting, the dominant position, the ground and pound, choosing his openings, picking apart Daichi Abe.
Paint shield right there is the only thing preventing Ev Ting from getting past that guard and ending up in a more dominant position. I'm sure he'd like to end the position.
Malaysian martial arts. Let's go to Tom Lau. Make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 44 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of rear naked choke.
It's another meltdown in Malaysia.
It's brought to you by The Mummy. Don't blink. Santos in the dark trunks. Kadestam in the blue and white.
Watch for these knees from Sapo. Kadestam likes to move forward, and the timing of Sapo's knees is
precise. Goodness me. The heaviness of that kick and the sound just reverberated around the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Sapo's nice and relaxed in there. You gotta wonder, is the title challenger and the champion in the welterweight division, Askren and Tani, backstage? They've gotta have a close eye on this fight here.
Santos certainly wants to be the next challenger, and I'm certain that Kadestam would want something similar. Massive
nice
kick.
Inside leg kick there. Immediately, you can see the damage inflicted on that leg.
It completely displaced that lead leg, didn't it?
I'd like to see Kadestam come back with something. He's just eating some of these shots. He's not throwing anything of his own. He's not going to be handling these thunderous kicks very much longer.
And that push kick just above the knee potentially could hyperextend that lead leg as well. It's already starting to get very red on that very fair, pale body. Left and a right from the Brazilian, and he goes for that push kick again above the knee. Could be very damaging indeed. The spinning back fist didn't quite land, caught the gloves only. You dare not take your eyes off this one. And there's a hush around the Singapore Indoor Stadium that until now has been pretty noisy.
It's like the entire crowd is just waiting on pause for a huge shot to come out of Sapo. Kadestam attempts a spinning kick there. Looks like he connected with just that right side, possibly the liver there of Sapo. Now Kadestam seems like he's moving forward a little bit. He's lit, shake out those jitters. The bright lights of one might be getting to him.
Well, there's no hurry, 15 minute contest. We're not yet halfway through the first round. It makes some noise, doesn't it, when Sapo lands that kick.
I don't know what's louder, the crowd reacting or the shot itself.
Well, I think he slipped there, but that could be his downfall.
I don't think so, Steve. I think he timed that leg kick perfectly. As Kadestam came forward, Sapo swept out that leg, and that's what put him on the mat. Sapo, a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt now, who's been trained extensively at American Top Team out there in Florida, working on his wrestling and trying to perfect that ground game as much as possible.
We immediately think that the danger that comes from Sapo is in the stand-up and those knees and those kicks, but he is very, very useful in this position, Mitch, isn't he?
I like the way he stepped over the butterfly hook with his right leg there, so he kind of pins it up there, so he's probably transitioning over into side control. He pushes down that knee and starts to move out. Now he's, Kadestam still got his hook since he steps over that leg, and now he's gonna slowly advance his position. Step by step, figure fours his legs. You can see he's got the triangle there on the right leg.
Sapo walk to finish. Action, boss.
Sapo's got his left arm around the head and he's inching that arm up. See how he's posturing, but he's pushing that arm up there. He's probably attempting an arm triangle. Kadestam, be careful not to let that left arm get too close to his head. Does the right thing by shoving it down.
1 minute left in the first round. This is 3 5-minute rounds you're about to see. Judges will score this contest in its entirety, not round by round. We'll get to Rich Franklin for his views on how the first 5 minutes have gone momentarily.
Very step-by-step, methodical ground game shown by Sapo.
We don't see him on the deck that often. We don't see him that often.
Oh, postures up, starts letting those hands go a little bit. In the last 30 seconds of the fight, Kadestam tried to hook that outside leg, but...
Oh, heavy knees to the head, and that's damaging. And you can see that that left hand trying to do all it can to block them, but there's some blood.
Look at the way he's winding up that knee.
It's coming from way back, isn't it? There's a cut on the forehead.
He showed the knees from the standing position, but he's got knees from the bottom position as well.
One round is in the books. And many thought it wouldn't go that far. The size of these men, it could all be over with one blow.
Let's take a look at some of these kicks thrown. There you see, he swept the leg, went right after the heel, hooked that leg, put Kadestam on the ground, and then just got on top and was very methodical in his ground game. He tried to pass the guard, got that, looks like he's attempting a possible choke here, but then the knees coming to the top of the head. Rich, how do you have that round?
Listen, the first half of this round was all about striking superiority. And all the strikes, they were one at a time, basically. But everything that Santos landed was just heavy. You could hear it. I actually awarded Santos takedown points for that sweep. I agree with you, Mitch. I believe that he timed that sweep and earned the takedown. Once they were on the ground, he mounted some good ground and pound there, and we actually scored that in the ground control category. So as of right now, I have Santos ahead on every single category. 5 minutes into this match, Santos is way ahead on the scorecards.
Yeah, you can see from the replay, it certainly was a sweep. You're dead right. He did not slip. I was wrong about that. So Santos ahead on the scorecard, or at least Rich's scorecard so far. Yuji Shimada just does a little bit of housekeeping. Throws the towel over the cage wall, almost lands on my head. Second round.
You can see how far back Santos keeps that left leg. You can see it's almost chambered, it's cocked, it's ready to unload at any point in time. Whether it's a knee or a kick, he really likes to set that up, but what he's not able to do from that position is kick from his back leg, or his front leg rather, so he can't really throw any front push kicks or level up. But he's also, so when you see him start to change his stance, you can tell he's setting up for something different coming from those legs.
A lot of people thought that when that accidental eye poke took place in that fight with Ben Askren, that Luis Santos was starting to gas a little bit. Here we are though, into the second round. He's still looking fresh.
Yeah, Steve. Santos said that he has spent extensive time working on his strength and conditioning because he never wants that to happen again. He never wants to ever question his cardio in a fight.
Well, he's light on his feet at the moment.
Yeah, you can see the way that leg's coming back.
Let's walk, champ.
Nice little leg body kick there.
The difference in speed between the two when they kick is what's really noticeable.
The anticipation, you can just kind of, everybody's at hush, is falling over the crowd as they're waiting for one of those big strikes to just explode out of Santos.
Rarely is the Singapore crowd as hushed as they are now. It is, as you say, the anticipation of an enormous blow that could end this one. And both men more than capable of that.
He's moving back and forth. Kadestam trying to move forward, but good job by Santos to duck under and secure a double leg takedown.
Kadestam has 6 TKOs to his name. Santos, 36. He's had an awful lot of fights.
Landed by Santos. You can see the closed guard from Kadestam. He's trying to shrimp out now, so he's trying to move his hips out to the side.
Watch up.
Trying to carry some sort of offense from the bottom, but when you have somebody as strong as Santos is on top of you, it's easier said than done.
Elbows to the face and to the top of the head there. Pressing on the throat and the elbow to the ear as well. A lot of damage.
Short elbows, Steve. That's what's doing the damage in this position. So he's not gonna, Kadestam's not gonna get a stand up here because Santos is being so active from this position. Landing the body shots, elbows. I'd like to see him try to advance his position a little bit. That guard doesn't look like it's doing too much to hold on to it. Yeah. See that he's trying to push down, but if he just pushes down on that right leg, he might be able to step out.
Deep penetrative punches, those left hands to the side of Kadestam's body. They look heavy.
Everything Santos does is heavy. Everything. Walking down the ramp, I could hear him stomping down the ramp. Everything
break,
does is heavy.
Break,
well, Yuji wants to see them standing up.
Watch out! Watch out! Stay active. Go. To keep moving when you're on the ground. Otherwise, Yuji wants to see some action. He's got to keep you moving. There's another one. Like, see Santos start putting some combinations together like he did in the first round, throwing those big shots one after the other. But I gotta say, when you start throwing kicks, that's a huge energy drain. I don't know if there's much else besides possibly picking somebody up and slamming them other than throwing these kicks. Again, he goes after that sweep to that leg. Beautiful.
Second time he's done that.
Timing is excellent. I spoke about it when he has the timing with the knees, but he's also got some stellar timing when it comes to that sweep on that foot. He waits for his opponent to step forward, put weight on that foot, and then sweep it out from under him.
Brilliantly done. Entering the last half minute of this second round.
30 seconds in the second round.
Singapore Indoor Stadium, totally focused on this one. We've got 2 world titles ahead of us. There's enough to be concerned with for everybody here, right in front of them.
Santos seems content to sit here in the full guard of Kadestam and drop a little bit of ground and pound. I don't know if that's fatigue or if that's part of his strategy to try to suck the energy out of Kadestam. But that first round was highly shifted towards Santos, but I don't think Kadestam did enough in the second round really to sway Rich's scorecards in any one of the manners. But there's a big takedown, and that was kind of the biggest moment of that round right there. We can see the body cam coming off of Yuji Shimada from as Luis Sapo Santo starts to drop some of that ground and pound. Here's that timing of that leg sweep. Beautifully done. Just waits, catches him off balance, and takes this fight back down to the ground. Let's go to Rich Franklin and see how he has that one.
I wanted to pull up the whole graphic on this fight so you can see how lopsided it is. I'm giving Kadestam, I actually reversed these. That should have been blue the other direction.
Well, we get it, okay.
Yeah, I've given Kadestam some aggression points because he's in the fight. You could, in the first replay there, you could see a knee that kind of glanced as Santos was coming in. Maybe you could score something like that. I've literally scored one leg kick for Kadestam in the first round and one spin kick in the second round. So his deficit here on the striking superiority, the takedowns, the ground control, and Santos has already accumulated damage. After 10 minutes of action in this round, I believe that Kadestam would have to stop this fight, knock out, submission, something in order to win.
So no way back for Kadestam, according to Rich Franklin, unless he can get a stoppage victory. That is quite a struggle for him then. Santos, whoa, remains light on his feet. Light enough to do a nice 360 there, kicking nothing but air.
The expression of Santos seems to have changed. He's not quite as intense as he was before. A little bit of a sloppy shot, telegraphed from all the way to the other side of the cage. Kadestam saw it coming, but Santos, just so strong, is able to lock his hands and take this fight back down.
Yeah, big strength to do that, particularly when you consider that Kadestam was on the cage wall, and it would have been even more difficult to lift him up and drop him down.
Kadestam easily stands up right in front of us here. Santos burying his head into the chest of Kadestam. He's got the body lock. Kadestam's got to create some movement. Santos has got to attempt something, otherwise Yuji Shimada is going to break these guys apart. A little bit of defensive striking there from Kadestam. He can create a little bit of space and start to circle out. Outside trip rather there from the judo black belt Santos. Now he's back into the guard of Kadestam. See if he tries to work for anything to advance the position or if he's going to be content just to stay in the full guard, because he's not really in any danger. Kadestam hasn't tried to throw up any submissions. He hasn't really thrown any strikes. Little scissor sweep attempt there, possibly, but he gives Santos his back. But he's able to get back up to his feet.
Some of you may have noticed Kadestam was fearful of a cut. He wiped his face and had a look to see if there was any blood on his glove there. Seems fairly clear. There is a little nick up there, high on the forehead.
Another diving takedown from Sampo as Kadestam goes right into the knee.
Yeah, he's looking for the knee to the head straight away, and Sampo is in a little bit of trouble there, and that's another heavy blow.
Delivered two huge knees.
Said that he needed to stop this fight in order to win it, and that's precisely what the doctor ordered.
What a huge upset! Kadestam beautifully was able to stop the takedown and deliver two huge knees.
And I'm sure he'll be looking very closely at the World Welterweight Contest that is going to happen later tonight here in the Singapore Indoor Stadium, because he has just put himself at the very front of the queue to be the next challenger. Meanwhile, Sapo is still lying down on his back, but the stretcher has been ushered away as far as I can tell, so he seems like he's okay. Rich, give us your thoughts on that tremendous stoppage.
You know, it's crazy, but Mitch said, I said that he needed to stop the fight in order to win this. I'll tell you, during the second round, I was really kind of questioning what Santos was thinking, because his volume had completely dropped off. Like, the strikes he was throwing, his aggression level had dropped. And when he had such control like he did in the first round, you know, Kadestam had landed basically one leg kick that had scored. Maybe something else that I missed, but the point is that there was nothing significant. And for him to have dropped off, it was just crazy. What a turnaround, amazing.
I think he's actually close to tears. What a victory. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the third round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Zebaztian Kadestam!
Coming inside the sold-out Hall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Eduard Folayang, the former ONE lightweight world champion.
former UFC and Bellator world champion. Wild hooking punches from both men, but Alvarez may have drawn the short straw on that exchange. Overhand right from Alvarez, trying to lock on a guillotine early here. The wushu striking of Folayang. Hands like slabs of granite. And the leg kicks are thumping. But Alvarez can brawl, can get on the inside and make it a dogfight, make it vicious. The turning back kick from Folayang. He goes to the liver section. Gotta watch the turning liver kicks, gotta watch the cutting side kicks.
I like that left hook of Folayang right now. It's really trying to find a home on Eddie's chin. You can see him testing it, but Eddie says he wants to test Folayang's chin. Folayang's been knocked out tremendously in some of his past matches, and Eddie wants to test that. That movement fading already.
Folayang hooks the punch, then goes the uppercut off the right hand. A high round kick, the spinning back fist, the outside leg kick from Folayang. Putting together the combinations early on is Edward Folayang of the Philippines.
Like those spins caught by Eddie. He
hurt him.
Trying to work his way in the mount. This is that topside jiu-jitsu we were talking about, Michael. And
Folayang gets his back. His foot down. This is not good from Folayang. Alvarez will take his time. He'll try and work the choke.
Oh, look
his
at him. Look at that chin.
This could be the beginning of the end. That's a good night, Irene. Eddie Alvarez is back. Eddie Alvarez is back. And he's booked his ticket to Tokyo.
Wow, Eddie Alvarez got hurt with the leg kick, fell down. Edward tried to finish him on the ground, throwing the ground and pound. Eddie survived the ground and pound, was able to utilize a beautiful sweep, end up on top, take the back of Folayang and sink in a rear naked choke, and advance his way into the finals of the Lightweight World Grand Prix, where he's gonna take on Doggy Hussein Arsalan Aliyev. Watch the leg kick. Look at that beautiful head movement, touches him on the chin with that hook again, and then he goes after the leg. Lands a huge leg kick, drops Folayang. Folayang was able to jump all over him, tries to finish him with good ground and pound. Eddie survived the ground and pound, utilized that veteran experience. Sweeps Folayang back on top and then finishes him with a rear naked choke. Absolutely beautiful. The drama of the lightweight tournament, Michael, is just too much for me, man. Look at this, pulls up the chin, look at it, prying the neck up, slides his right hand right underneath the chin, sinks in the rear naked choke, and then Folayang is forced out of the Lightweight World Grand Prix. There's the tap right there.
A tremendous match brought to you by sponsor MG Motor. Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
To present the fellow for this match, we have Senior Vice President and Director, Marketing Communication Services of the Covenant Car Company Incorporated, Lynn M. Wena. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 16 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke and advancing to the ONE Lightweight World Grand Prix Final, Eddie Alvarez.
It will be Alvarez versus Doggy Arsalan Aliyev in October in the final. If you don't know who Doggy is, look him up after this event, because you know that Eddie Alvarez is going to be in for one hell of a contest.
That's Vitaly Bigdash. Fight. That is Igor Svirid. This is the ONE Championship middleweight title brought to you by TuneTalk, more than just a prepaid.
Both these fighters got some big finishes in their careers, and I expect some fireworks here tonight.
We're looking for that strong left jab from Svirid. Taigi's a world star to this contest. Furious, furious punching from both men.
Bigdash didn't want much of that as he immediately shot in for the takedown after that ferocious exchange of combination.
Stunning left jab from Svirid, and down goes Bigdash. It was a rock of a left jab, like the one that stunned Leandro Ataides, and Svirid doesn't want any of that. Get back up on your feet, he says. We're doing the stand-up.
Svirid's got some explosive punching power as he just jumps out of the gate throwing his hands. This might be just a moment in time that it's...
Big right hand for the champion, and down goes Bigdash again. The hammer blows come in, ground and pound, more hammer blows with the right hand. It's all Bigdash could do to cover up. Svirid circles round, looks for the bigger opportunity. That was a huge punch. And it was the strength of that jab that set it all up. And again, Svirid says, get up, we're doing this standing up.
Svirid is showing that dynamic punching power that actually won him the belt, and he intends to keep it with that same power.
Watch for that jab. It stunned Ataides, and it's done the same thing in this fight. It's a great opening salvo.
Bigdash has got to do something here different to change the complexity of this fight. Things are not going his way. And the crowd is starting to chant.
Huge crowd here at Stadium Putra. They've been very noisy all evening. Another big right hand from Svirid. Two of them, in fact. Bigdash knows he's in a real rumble here.
But to Bigdash's credit, he is standing in there and not going nowhere. He says, let's go, let's do this. There's that jab again.
Again, the jab. What a stunning, stunning weapon that is. And I think we'll see Svirid back off. Yep, there we are.
Little glove touches. Get up, let's go.
To the cheers of the crowd, Mitch. They're loving this stand-up, and who can blame them? What action we've got here in Stadium Putra. And we're only halfway through the first round. Potentially 5 rounds of this to come.
If this goes 5 rounds, I can't imagine the roof is going to stay on this stadium.
I think we'll all be a bit stunned if it goes that far.
Oh my goodness me!
Once again, the jab, and down come the hammer blows once more. Olivier Costa is standing by. What can Vitaly Bigdash do to defend himself? The knee to the head sends him back onto his back. Again, the hammer blows from Svirid.
Oh, Bigdash breaks the trap!
Oh, very nice indeed now. The turnaround. The armbar.
Oh, it's deep!
Slips out. What tremendous action. Both men now on the ground.
Bigdash uses the sweep to get back up on top. This is the first time we've seen Svirid on his back.
And he's breathing hard, Mitch.
What a huge expenditure of energy shown by our champion,
somebody's
Igor Svirid.
It's Vitaly Bigdash who's cut.
Bigdash has weathered the storm. He's taken some tremendous blows and is now working on top. We've got to wonder about what kind of energy that would cost Igor Svirid to unleash those bombs.
Svirid
like that.
Is breathing so hard. He's laying his head back and taking a breather whenever he can, but he's under the cosh at the moment. Bigdash has made a phenomenal comeback with a minute left in this opening round.
Punching from the bottom position is Svirid, while Bigdash works to pass the guard.
Good work from Bigdash, punching to the head and body, and again Svirid tries to take a breather, putting that head back on the canvas. He's exhausted himself, and who can blame him after this furious assault he laid on in the first 4 minutes?
Yeah, Svirid's just got to bide his time, let himself recover a little bit.
Elbow from Vitaly there, the left elbow into Svirid's face.
And we're just face to face with Vitaly Bigdash as he's dropping bombs.
Oh, they're heavy as well, Mitch, aren't they? Into the side, into the rib cage. Back comes Svirid, the champion. 10 seconds left. Two knees to the head. Svirid still on.
He's dropped down.
He's dropped to his knees, but he's still got his win.
there's a tremendously big cut on Svirid's head now, or at least an awful lot of blood. I think it's from him. And that must have come from the knee. Such a swathe of action there in the last few seconds. There is an enormous cut on Svirid's head as we look at what happened there in the first round.
Here's those punches where Igor Svirid dropped Bigdash. Oh, that big right hand comes over the top, rocks him, and he drops to his back. And here's these punches again with that left jab, puts Bigdash down. And then Igor jumps in the ground and pound. This is where I think he expended most of his energy. He really thought he had the finish. There's a big knee from Bigdash.
Let's look and see if there was a tap, because the arm, there's the rear naked choke.
It's in deep. There's a lot of flailing around right there, but I think the bell
Olivier
went
Cost,
off.
Yeah, removed the arm just as the bell rang. While we were watching those replays, there was up to close to a dozen people around Svirid's stool looking at the cut on his forehead. It looks crystal clear now. They've done a fantastic job on it. Perhaps it just looked a lot worse than it actually was. If you've seen a more action-packed 5 minutes than that, I want to hear about it and I want to see it, because that was stunning action. And potentially four more rounds to come. The blood drips down from that actually quite small cut on the forehead once again. How will that affect this contest?
Vitaly Bigdash is showing a tremendous heart by withstanding the storm as he tries to spin into attack.
And he did it again with that left jab. That was the first punch thrown by Svirid. What a title fight this is. Again, that heavy jab.
I gotta see if Igor Svirid can deliver that same sort of punching power after the end of our round one. What a shocker! Vitaly Bigdash knocks out Igor Svirid in one of those dramatic title fights we have ever seen at ONE Championship.
This may be early days, but rematch anyone? Wow!
What a tremendous showing. You can see it right here with that big knee that rocked him, and then the right hand comes over the top. Vitaly Bigdash jumps in with the hammerfish. Olivia Cost dives in to save him. There's the knee and the right hand combination. And just these ground and pound by Vitaly Bigdash as he wins the World Championship.
Well, I'm exhausted. I'm looking at you, Mitch. You're breathing hard. Oh. These two provided such stunning entertainment. Olivier Cost putting his body on the line there to save Igor Svirid from any more punishment. He has lost his middleweight title, and we have a new champion in 31-year-old Vitaly Bigdash, whose official record climbs to 8-0. This unbeaten middleweight is your new ONE Championship title holder. And listen to this crowd. Stadium Putra. They love that. I hope you did at home.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Cost calls a halt to this battle at 36 seconds of round number two for your winner via referee stoppage due to strikes and new ONE Middleweight World Champion, Vitaly Bigdash.
Tremendous sportsmanship from both of these fighters.
Ready?
For Angela Lee. Fight. Round one, five-minute rounds ahead of us potentially. Good start from Nunes, who connects with that left kick to the head.
This is definitely Nunes's world. She's had so much experience in the Muay Thai field that, you know, we gotta wonder at what point is Angela gonna choose to attempt to take this fight to the ground.
Right hand from Nunes with a counter blow. She's quick with those kicks upstairs, isn't she?
Yeah, but I like how Angela's immediately starting to cut the angles off of Nunes. She's got her up against the cage, eliminating the space that she's able to move around in.
Just ate a very solid jab from Nunes, and this crowd are really getting involved. Angela there, Singapore, they're shouting, forgive me. But the Singapore fighter takes another kick to the head. And Nunes is giving more than her fair share of the offense so far. Inside the first minute,
But the more kicks Nunes chooses to throw, it's going to get the odd. That's it. There is that space, the clinch. This is where Angela usually takes fights to the ground once she gets into the clinch.
Pressing the Brazilian up against the cage wall, giving her no room to work whatsoever.
Nunes wants to frame out. She's got a frame. Oh, nice headlock takedown from the champion.
What a roar from the crowd here as that takedown put into effect.
And this is Angela's world. She's trying to pin down that arm there with that left leg as she's slowly starting to maneuver around. Nunes doing a good job of framing off with that knee, keep a little bit of space. The feet are probably gonna go to the hips pretty soon. You can see her trying to slide that foot into the hip, create even more space.
Immense experience Angela Lee has, albeit just 20 years of age. Just had a little sneaky look at the elbow there, didn't work out for her.
She thought about it. You can see that now she's in the full guard of Istela. So you can see she frames underneath. She's got that underhook now on one side. She's got an overhook on the other.
Istela tries to pull her in first from the back of the head. Now just restricting the movement of Angela's arms. Keeping her close, denying her any leverage. Angela scoots around or tries to.
Passes the guard there, Steve. That's huge. She's got past the guard, but now Estella's got her back up against the cage and she's gonna try to walk up that cage. Lee's probably gonna try to scoot her around, get her back away from the cage so she can keep her there in position. Up, back into half guard, that's okay.
Elbow and then fist to the stomach from Angela Lee. More.
She's using that left leg of hers to kind of shield away from Angela from her to create a little bit more defensive posture. See, she's able to push away from it, trying to get back up to her feet. Angela immediately swarms on her, jumps onto her back.
And she's
got one hook in, and looks like she's got two hooks in.
Crowd absolutely roaring her on here, Mitch.
Oh, Angela's got a lot of finishes from the back. She's gonna try to flatten her out. This is a bad spot for Nunes to be in.
Coming up to the final minute and a half of the opening round. Remember, there'll be five 5-minute rounds here.
It's important for Nunes. Oh, now look at this. She's got that leg triangled around her other one and the leg underneath it. She's got it very, this is called a, she might be setting up another one of those twisters, man. Nunes has got to be real careful. Don't let that hand go by.
Surely not another twister.
That's what it looks like, Steve. That's it. It's in.
It's the signature move. Surely not in a world title defense. It looks hard. Istela Nunes doesn't look in too much discomfort, apart from the fact she's taking multiple punches to the head.
She's got a limp arm out. That right arm's got a limp arm, and she's got to slide out. That's it. She's taking some shots.
This is more than a dozen blows to the head now. Angela Lee piling on the pressure. The Singapore fans roaring their hearts out for her. Istela Nunes continues to resist.
That lockdown position right there in the legs is keeping her in this position, but look at Istela Nunes!
What heart the Brazilian has.
She's got a limp arm. That right arm has got to get out from underneath the armpit of Angela Lee.
She's unable to throw anything back, just consumed with defending, and she's only got one hand to do it.
Look at the foot there, Steve. She's trying to push off with her right leg. If she can push off with the right leg and create space, that's what's keeping her.
She almost had it there. The bell saves her. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but what a round from Angela Lee, and this crowd all around me on their feet going nuts.
What? Okay, so this was it. She got the overhook, she had the underhook, she used the headlock takedown to spin there. Now, once she had this fight onto the ground, it was a step-by-step process, very strategic. Here's some of that. She jumped onto the back. You can see her transition there, has that lockdown ground position there, triangling her legs and extending out. Keeps her pinned in that position. Once the hand of Istela Nunes, her arm rather, was behind the back of Angela Lee, Angela Lee had her pinned there and she was able to drop bombs. Rich, what do you got?
You can see the graphic there. I pulled up ground control, obviously on the ground. This was all Angela Lee. I did not award her any kind of points for the attempted submission on the twister. At the beginning of the round, I'll say this, Istela actually scored decently in the striking superiority category, so it's not like she's not on the board. This is obviously, the fight is in Angela Lee's favor at this point in time, but she hasn't created such a distance that Istela can't come back from this. Remember, this is a 5-round fight.
Yeah, 20 minutes to come. We've only seen 5. And Istela Nunes has shown us that she is here to stick around and do some damage while she does. And she starts this first round pretty much as she did, this second round pretty much as she did the first, with good hands. And Angela Lee will have to be very careful of that overhand right from Nunes, and that landed right on the button.
Istela Nunes survived the worst possible scenario. That has to have her confidence really high heading into this second round with the champion.
And remember, as Nunes sets up this attack with her fists, her real power comes from her legs. She can kick up to the head with devastating results. And Angela Lee will be mindful of that.
See, immediately Angela Lee is cutting off the angles, trying to get her pressed up against the cage. Typically, Angela doesn't like to shoot for a lot of takedowns. She gets most of her takedowns from the clinch position. So that's what Nunes has to be careful of in this next round.
It's quite clear that Angela wants the full contact. She wants to get in there close and nullify the attack that Nunes can provide in the stand-up.
Kick, went for the takedown, and delivered a knee as she was pinned up against the cage there.
More knees to the head. Istela gets up on her feet though. Angela tries to pull her down.
She's got her in the darce choke position. One hand under the neck, the other hand laced under her arm. She's trying to snap her down, goes for the outside trip. That's an anaconda choke, Steve. Collapses beautifully in the anaconda. That's tight.
She's saying she's okay. She's giving Olivier Coste the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance again from Istela Nunes.
Right there, she has to frame off her hands, create a little bit of space with that right arm. So the arm is, she's essentially getting choked with her own arm.
She's still giving Olivier the thumbs up. Tremendous resistance from the Brazilian, but Angela Lee's attack is furious.
Look at Nunes. Her head is pressed up against the side there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee has both arms nice and tight, but there is space for Nunes to breathe. Her right arm is not completely tight to her back.
I think she touched it. She's done it. Couldn't last forever. Angela Lee has made her second successful defense of a world title. The tears are already falling. She's done it again. The roar around me at the Singapore Indoor Stadium is deafening. Into the arms of her father, Ken Lee, who's coached her since she was a young girl. And the emotion is evident for all to see. The resistance from Istela Nunes was strong. And right up until the very final moment, it looked like it was going to continue. But there's the relief. A picture for all of Singapore to look at and be proud. Christian Lee, her brother, giving her a hug. Mitch, take us through these final moments. Rich Franklin is with us as well. Rich, just take us through these final moments.
I tell you, it's just to watch Angela Lee do this. I mean, she's been able to pull off an anaconda, a twister, guillotine chokes, arm bars. It's crazy. And you know, you saw her prior to this actually working the snap down, trying to earn that takedown. And then she was set in this kind of anaconda choke position from the standing position the whole time and ended up working it to the trip where she earned that position. It's just amazing to see the different angles that she's able to work various submissions from. She's always looking for something.
Well, Dom Lau has the official decision, and you can bet that it is going to be met with rapturous cheers from the crowd here in Singapore.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this bout, we have Mr. Roger Chen, GoDaddy's Vice President of Asia. And now, your referee, Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the second round. for your winner by way of anaconda choke, and still one women's atomweight champion of the world, unstoppable Angela Lee!
Istela Nunes falls to 5-1. The champion Angela Lee improves to 8-0. She screams at the camera